Good morning, students. Yesterday we have started the chemical properties of the haloarenes, and what we did that is the nucleophilic substitution of haloarene is difficult. So they do not undergo nucleophilic substitution easily. So we did the reasons, that is resonance, polarity of CX bond in haloarenes. Then we did the hybridization. So due to all that factors, nucleophilic substitution reaction takes place with difficulty in the case of haloarenes. So today we will do few nucleophilic substitution reactions of haloarenes. So if we are having chlorobenzene in presence of sodium hydroxide at temperature 623 and 300 atmosphere, that is at elevated temperature and high pressure, only under these conditions they will undergo nucleophilic substitution. So first there is formation of sodium phenoxide, and then on further reaction with dilute HCl there is formation of phenol. And this process is called as a Dose process. Then next is the reaction with the ammonia in the presence of cuprous oxide at 475 Kelvin and 60 atmosphere. Again the conditions are drastic. In these conditions, under these conditions, it is forming aniline, cuprous chloride plus water. Then bromobenzene reacts with CuCN, copper cyanide, in the presence of base, again at 475 Kelvin, that is at high temperature, it will form benzene nitride plus copper bromide. Now in all these reactions, conditions are drastic, that is high temperature and pressures are required for the nucleophilic substitution of the halogen. Now this benzene nitrile, which is formed, it is very useful product to form number of products. For example, if we do the acid hydrolysis of benzene nitrile, there is formation of benzoic acid. And if we do partial hydrolysis or alkaline hydrolysis, we will get benzamide. And on reducing agent, it is reduced to, that is, amine. Now is the effect of substituents in haloarenes on the reactivity. Now what is there? Presence of electro withdrawing groups such as NO2, CN, COOH, etc. at ortho and para positions to the halogen atom greatly activates the halogen towards the nucleophilic substitution. That is, if these electron withdrawing groups are present at ortho and para position to the halogen atom in the benzene ring, then nucleophilic substitution takes place easily. So why is it so? Now it is due to the resonance. Now what is there? If we take the case of orthonitrochlorobenzene and there is nucleophilic substitution by OH negative, which is acting as a nucleophile, so it takes place in two steps. So first step is a slow step in which there is attack of OH negative with the carbon of the carbon to which Cl is attached. Now as a result, what will be there? Due to this, negative charge appears on the this carbon, which is at the ortho position. Now in resonating structure, now this charge is, electrons are moving here, and now this electrons are moving towards the carbon which is attached with the nitro group. Now this structure is a main structure. Now here this carbon, which is having negative charge, is attached to the electron withdrawing group, that is NO2. So it is stabilizing it. So this is a main step which is stabilizing this resonating structure. Now in the next step, these electrons will go further and they will be shifting further. So we will get these kind of resonating structure in which the negative charge revolves at the ortho and para positions. And second step is a fast step in which the Cl negative will move, leaving its electrons on this carbon, and there is formation of orthonitrophenol. Now what is there in this structure? Negative charge on carbon atom with which electron withdrawing nitro group is attached. So negative charge is stabilized and it facilitates the nucleophilic substitution. Now what is there? If we are having metanitrophenol, then there is none of the structure has negative charge on the carbon ring having electron withdrawing nitro group. So there is no effect on reactivity when nitro group is present at meta position. So if these groups are either present at ortho position or at para position, they will be stabilizing the negative charge present on the carbon atom. Whereas there is no charge, negative charge at meta position, so that's why there is no stabilization, and hence there is no effect on reactivity when nitro group is present at meta position. Now it is here, it is justified like this. For example, if we are taking the simple chlorobenzene, then we have to, if we want to react it with the sodium hydroxide, we have to elevate the temperature, that is 623, and high pressure, that is 300 atmosphere, only then there is formation of phenol. Now if we are having para, then what is their temperature is reduced to 443 Kelvin. Now if we are having electron withdrawing groups such as nitro group at ortho and para, then the temperature is reduced to 368. Now if these groups are present at ortho, all ortho and para positions, then the temperature is still further reduced, that is 323, and we will get the formation of this 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. Now what is there? Nitro group meta to the chlorine has no effect on reactivity. Then next type of reaction is the reaction with metals. Now first we will do the reaction with magnesium. Now it reacts with magnesium. For example, if we take bromobenzene, it reacts with magnesium in the presence of diether, and there is formation of phenyl magnesium bromide, which is a Grignard reagent, and this reagent is very important reagent for certain reactions. Then is the reaction with lithium. So bromobenzene react with lithium in the presence of dry lithium, and there is formation of phenyl lithium. Then there is important reaction, that is Woods-Fittig reaction, in which chlorobenzene reacts with sodium, and there is one haloalkane, that is chloromethane. So what is there? There is formation of toluene, and this reaction is called as Woods-Fittig reaction. And if we are taking two molecules of chlorobenzene in presence of sodium and diether, there is formation of biphenyl, and this is a Fittig reaction. Then next is a reaction with copper powder. Two molecules of iodobenzene react with copper. On heating, there is formation of biphenyl and cuprous iodide. So this particular reaction is called as Ullmann reaction. Then is the reduction. Now reduction of chlorobenzene leads to the formation of benzene. So nickel aluminium alloy, that is Rene-Nickel, is taken. So in presence of that is hydrogenation takes place, and there is formation of benzene. All these reactions which we did, they are of the reactions of halogen present with the benzene ring. Now next kind of reaction is a ring substitution or electrophilic substitution reaction. These are the reactions of the benzene ring. Now what is there? X, that is halogen. Halogen is ortho and para direct. So the groups which have to come, that is electrophile, will attach at the ortho and para positions. So it is showing major 4-5 type of reactions. So what is there? First of all, that is halogenation. So chlorobenzene reacts with chlorine in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, which is a Lewis acid. In presence of that, or you can say it is chlorinating agent, in presence of that, there is formation of ortho and para product, that is 1,2-dichlorobenzene and 1,4-dichlorobenzene. And here the major product is para, because it is most stable due to symmetry. Then next is a nitration. Now nitration takes place in presence of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. Now this nitro group, which is an electrophile, it will come at the ortho and para position, and there is formation of 2-nitrochlorobenzene and 4-nitrochlorobenzene, or you can say ortho-nitrochlorobenzene and para-nitrochlorobenzene. Then next reaction is sulfonation. Now sulfonation takes place in presence of concentrated H2SO4. Here SO3H group, that comes at ortho and para positions. Then is the CH3Cl, that is chloromethane, in presence of again anhydrous AlCl3, which is a Lewis acid. In the presence of this, there is formation of ortho and para product, in which ortho chlorotoluene and para chlorotoluene will be formed. And this reaction is also called as Friedel-Crafts alkylation. That is, alkyl group will attach at the ortho and para position. Then next is the reaction with RCOCl or CH3COCl, again in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. Now this reaction is called as Friedel-Crafts acylation. That is, acyl group, that is COCH3 or COR group, is attached at the ortho and para position. So these are the products which are formed. So under all this, that is halogenation, nitration, sulfonation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation or acylation, electrophiles attack at the ortho and para position. So in general, we can say that is the halorenes are ortho and para directly. So these are the main points of this chapter. Now go through this chapter. We will do questions tomorrow. Thank you.